Good morning, students. Today's class is about leaf anatomy. Leaf anatomy is the study of internal structure of dicot and monocot leaf. First of all, let's see the internal structure of dicot leaf. Our book deals with the leaf of a mango tree. Dicot leaf is a dorsiventral leaf. So in dorsiventral leaf, there are different layers: upper epidermis, lower epidermis, mesophyll tissue, and vascular bundle. So first let's see the upper epidermis. It is a single layer made up of parenchyma without space, without intercellular space, and lined by a thin cuticle. So you can give a term, cuticularized. And there are no stomata or less number of stomata. So in a dicot leaf, there are less number of stomata in the upper epidermis. Is it clear? Next, we shall go to the lower epidermis. It is similar to that of upper epidermis, but slightly vary in few things. In which one? It contains numerous stomata. So we saw, in upper epidermis, stomata are less in number, whereas in lower epidermis, stomata are numerous. What's the use of the stomata? It helps in the exchange of gases. Also in transpiration. What is transpiration? The loss of water vapor. So about lower epidermis, it is similar like upper epidermis, made up of parenchyma cells, thin cuticle, and it contains numerous stomata. It helps in the exchange of gases and transpiration. Now the third layer is mesophyll tissue. The mesophyll of a dorsiventral leaf is differentiated into palisade and spongy parenchyma. So two different layers, palisade and spongy. So a dorsiventral leaf mesophyll is differentiated into two layers. First one, palisade. The cells of this region are elongated, has more number of chloroplasts, and have intercellular spaces, so they take part in photosynthesis. So as you see, the cells contain chloroplasts, they take part in photosynthesis. Next one, spongy parenchyma. Now these cells, the cells of this layer are slightly vary from palisade. The cells are almost spherical or oval, irregularly arranged. They have intercellular spaces, and so it helps in gaseous exchange. The next layer, vascular bundle. So normally we describe vascular bundle by different terms. The previous video we saw. So the vascular bundle of a dorsiventral leaf or dicot leaf is described as conjoined, collateral, and closed. And each bundle is surrounded by a bundle sheath. Bundle sheath is made up of parenchyma cells. Is it clear? Okay. We are now clear with the dorsiventral leaf. Now we shall move on to isobilateral leaf structure. Monocot plant has isobilateral leaf structure. Mesophyll of isobilateral is not differentiated into palisade and spongy. In coming to isobilateral leaf, there are three important structures. First one is epidermis, second one is mesophyll, third one is vascular bundle. So we shall see the first layer, epidermis. It has upper and lower epidermis, cuticle stomata are present, and some specialized cells which are found in as large and thin walled called bulliform cells. So it is very peculiar in isobilateral leaf. Second structure is a mesophyll. It is not differentiated into palisade and spongy parenchyma. So all the cells are similar, and they have intercellular spaces, irregularly arranged. They contain chloroplasts. Third structure is the vascular bundle. Many number of bundles are found. Some of them are very small and some of them are very large. And each bundle is surrounded by a parenchymatous bundle sheath. So as in even every monocot root, stem, and leaf also, you have to describe the bundle by certain terms. So here also it is defined as adjoin, collateral and closed. Yes, is it clear? Internal structure of monocot leaf. Okay, a recap now. How do you differentiate dicot and monocot leaf? I hope you can find out yourself from the today's class. The very first point you can say, mesophyll is differentiated into two parts, upper palisade and lower spongy in a dicot leaf. I hope your point is also correct. Very good. So in monocot leaf, mesophyll is undifferentiated. Correct? How do you term this? When mesophyll is differentiated into two parts, upper palisade and lower spongy, you call it as dorsibundral. When mesophyll is undifferentiated, you term it as isobilateral. So the first point can be idorsibundral, isobilateral. Correct? Now, what can be the second difference? Very good. Stomata are absent or less abundant on the upper side. Stomata are equally distributed on the two sides in monocot leaf. What is the third point about the stomata? Stomata have kidney-shaped god cells. Stomata have dumbbell-shaped god cells. It's the third point. So you have three differences in dicot leaf and monocot leaf. So very prompt difference. As you see the picture or diagram of the leaf, you find it is dorsibundral or isobilateral. And the difference, and the one more difference is the about the stomata. Clear, girls? Okay. Today's assignment, draw and explain the structure of isobilateral leaf. That is a monocot leaf. Clear? Second homework is difference between a dicot and a monocot leaf. Thank you, girls. See you in the next class.